A very good morning to all my students. Today we are going to have science class day 3 and today we are going to discuss on pistil structure. Okay, and before we begin with the pistil structure and its explanation, I would like to have a quick recap of what we have studied in our last class. So in our last class we have studied about the four parts of a flower, that is calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. Fine. And we have also studied about the function of calyx, corolla and androecium. And we have also studied the structure of stamen. Okay. And its parts. And as I have instructed in the last class, that you have to pay attention towards the underlined portion. Can you see this? These are all key points that you have to incorporate when you are writing the answers. Okay, so today we will be discussing about pistil structure. Now, where do we find pistil? We find pistil in this part of the flower. Can you see the structure of a flower? We find pistil in this part of the flower. This is the fourth whorl, which is known as pistil. And this is also known as female reproductive unit, which is also known as gynoecium. Clear? Now let's study about pistil in detail. Now let's see the pistil structure. Okay, I have drawn here so that you can understand it very clearly. Now pistil consists of three parts: stigma, style, ovary. Okay. Stigma, style and ovary are the three parts of pistil. Let's start with stigma first. So what is stigma? Okay, stigma is the sticky, swollen tip of the pistil. It is responsible for receiving the pollen grains. Okay, so this is the part where it receives pollen grains. Clear? Now, we'll move on to style. Okay, now style is a thin, long tube-like structure that connects stigma to the ovary. Okay, it connects stigma to the ovary. So it plays like a connection. Okay, now then we'll come to the third part, that is ovary. Okay, now ovary is the swollen base of the pistil. It consists of ovules. Can you see this parts? Can you see this part? These are all ovules. Okay, ovules. The ovules contains eggs or female gametes. So this part, can you see this round, small round part? These are all eggs. It's also known as female gametes. Okay, so after fertilization, the ovary, this whole thing, the ovary forms fruit. So this will turn and it will become a fruit. It will convert to become a fruit. And whereas the ovules, now can you see this ovules? Okay, this ovules will turn and become seeds. Okay, this will happen after fertilization. So after fertilization, this whole part, ovary, will become a fruit and this ovules will convert into seeds. Clear? So ovary contains the female reproductive cell called ovules. So this ovary converts into a fruit and ovules turns into seeds. So this is the whole process, that is the formation of fruit as well seeds. So let's get to the definition of gynoecium. Okay, that is, the gynoecium is usually located at the center of the flower. It is the collection of the female reproductive unit, okay, called carpels or pistils. Now gynoecium may consist of single pistils or a group of pistils. A pistil has three parts, that is stigma, style and ovary. Now what are stigma? Stigma is a sticky swollen tip of the pistil. It is responsible for receiving the pollen grains, as I have explained in the structure. Now style is a thin long tube like structure that connects the stigma to the ovary. And what is ovary? It is the swollen base of the pistil. It consists of ovules. The ovules contain egg or female gametes. After fertilization, the ovary forms the fruit of the plant, whereas ovules form the seeds. Clear? So here also I have marked all the key points. So when you are writing the definition, you have to incorporate the key points and write your answer. Hope you have understood all the parts of a flower, and I have explained in detail along with the diagrams. So you have to study very carefully. Okay, class? Thank you.